Yo, what's poppin', It's your boy Candle Trick or Chicken in, man. Like, comment, subscribe, do all the good shit for your boy, man. So, I'm finna pick back up off my last video, so go check my last video out, y'all, so y'all can know the whole story, you know, as I'm finna go on. So, Blair had this company called Kilgore come out, look at my truck or whatever. They're a wrecking company or whatever. He found out what was going on. He said, yo, brake chambers, everything good on your truck. He said, man, your air valve is leaking. Behind the fifth wheel, underneath the fifth wheel, it's an air valve. I think it's an ABS air valve, and it was leaking. So he was like, bro, I can't fix it, but you got to call a service technician out here to do it. He was like, man, it shouldn't take nothing but like an hour to do it. So I'm like, bro, you just really came out here for no reason. But he was real cool, so I wasn't really tripping. Plus, it wasn't the brake chambers or nothing like that, you know. So that was cool. It was a quick fix, you know. So shout out to Steven from Blur out of the maintenance department. Steven was like, bro, I'm finna go home, but I'm finna call around right quick, bro. Mind you, it's like 5 o'clock in the evening and everybody was saying they don't have the part, period. So I'm forgetting I'm near Birmingham and the terminal is in Birmingham. You know what I'm saying? I'm not even thinking that. I'm really right down the street from the terminal. So Steve was like, man, I got a plug. He didn't say plug, but he was like, man, I got a plug who I normally talk to. And he usually work at this time and he should have a part. So he said, man, I called my tire tech guy. He say he an hour away. He finna come out there and look at the part. He said, man, if he got the right part, he gonna go ahead and fix it right there. He said, man, if he don't got the right part, he gonna have to come back and get you in the morning. So boom. What I started doing was I called my insurance people like, hey, I might need to get towed, bro. You feel me? So mind you, with my insurance, they pay half for the tow, half of the tow bill. So I already had them on the horn. They was like, just call us if you need us. Cause I told them, I'm gonna see if this guy can come out here and do it. If he can't, I'm just gonna get towed up to the lug, cause I'm not gonna be on the side of this back road like for the rest of the night. So I was like, all right, boom. So that was my two options, bro. Either get it towed if bro couldn't fix it, or he was gonna fix it, which he did fix it, and he had the right part, man. Salute to him, man. I just appreciate them folks didn't leave your boy out there stranded, man. I just appreciate that, you know what I'm saying? So everybody who I talked to, I could get in touch with them. Even when the maintenance guy Steven, when he left, he made sure that I was took care of before he left, though, man. I said, little dude. So, man, I paid for the roadside, the first roadside that came out. I paid for that. And then the other guy, he came out. I guess Blur gonna take that out of my check. He was just like, man, we work for Blur, so it is what it is. So they'll take that out of my check or whatever. So, hey, we back rolling. That's all that matter. Like I say, man, this load right here is 3,500 going 741 miles. I'm in Knoxville. I'm halfway there. I'm on the border of Virginia and Tennessee right now. You feel me? So I got to get these, some trailer tires replaced or whatever. Cause mind you, the DOT told me like, you know, this week, the Blitz week and all this shit, you might want to get these tires replaced. So I'm finna go and get them replaced. I already called Blur. Blur was like, man, just go check in with the TA. They gonna call us with everything. I said, damn, that's an easy process. So Blur fixing the trailer, that's on them. They fixed the trailer. The trailer maintenance is on them, so they finna go ahead and do that. But we got this load of lumber, man. I've been hauling lumber. So, man, my first load coming out of Houston was it was a short load going 246 miles. It was for like $896. And then my second load, it was going like 300 miles for $1,000. So I was at 1,800 by Tuesday. And then I picked this $3,500 load up Wednesday. So this load gonna be, so then once I deliver this load right here, I'll be at $5,300 gross. So my weekend load, hopefully this jump be 2K, and then I'll be at $7,300. So yeah, so the pay period is from Monday to Monday. Basically, as long as you get your paperwork turned in before Monday at midnight, all that shit gonna go on there. So my weekend load, that's going on. to this pay period. So right now we at 5,300. I popped out Monday. I left out the crib Monday, and I'm staying out into the fucking following week for a couple weeks now. You know what I'm saying? So that's what I got going on. I want to let y'all know what was going on, bro. Like, shit, when the Earth Valve shit happened, bro, I ain't know what to expect, man. I was just like, damn, man, here we go again. You know what I'm saying? So, man, luckily I put the resources in play, man, and it's Chess, not Checkers. A lot of folks be like, man, why you go to Blur and all this shit like that? Shit, hey, they gonna front the bill for me. If I was in Mutual Transportation Group, guess what it would have been? Everything would have been on me. You know what I'm saying? So that shit, it fuck with your fuck with your cash flow, basically. It mess with your cash flow, bro. Having to dip out your pocket sometimes and shit like that. You want to be with a company, if you're an owner-operator, where if shit do go down to the point where you don't get it or you need some help with it, that they'll do it, you know? So that's why, another reason why I left Mutual. It wasn't no benefit, you know? They ain't got the, I'm pulling out the spot market. They ain't got the freight. Spot market ain't got the phrase. They only got 6 months of authority. It was a lot of crazy shit. So now, me being more experienced with this shit, I'm learning from a lot, bro. You know what I'm saying? And it's cool, man. But everybody want to know how everything going at Blur so far. I mean, so far, so good. It ain't the best, but, you know, in these times, it's cool, man. As long as they can keep me running. Like, I'm finna head out of Virginia. Shit, you know. Hopefully they find me something good going over the weekend. If not, I mean, that's just what it is. I'm just gonna keep running and doing my thing, man. And the money shit, that shit gonna add up. Cause like I say, my deductions a week ain't number $347 a week. 300 of that is my escrow. So I'm only paying $47 a week. And then on the first of every month, I'm only paying $400 and some dollars because some they do like monthly fees or whatever. So that's what's going on right now, man. We back rolling, man. It's all that matter. We back rolling. Shout out to the B, man. Shout out to the B. And I ain't talking about the blood gang. You dig? But, hey, everything good, man. Shit, I just want to say, happy to be alive, man. Shit, stuck on that back road, boy. Cars flying, trucks flying. Man, I'm just glad I ain't panicked. I'm just glad I handled my business how I handled my business. You feel me? So, I just want to say, man, I love y'all, man. We getting to it, man. We still doing it, man. $5,300 gross. Salute.